There's a theory that someone that's lived in a cage and had terrible things done to them for their whole life is wasted and ruined and crazy and not retirable. And these guys are showing that they can have a life.
Today on Animal Tracks, making a home for chimpanzees.
These guys deserve it so much.
More than 1,000 chimps in North America are being used for medical research. But where do they go when that research is finished? We'll watch as chimps arrive at their new home near Montreal.
So I'll be opening the stomach.
And a truly inside look at an animal pathologist. Who does the autopsies when animals die? We'll hear about some real-life detective work on the wild side. Hello, I'm Jill Deacon. Welcome to Animal Tracks, the show where we tell you about animals that are making news right around the world. We begin tonight with a growing problem that pits compassion against cold, hard reality. Around North America, in private and public labs, about 1,500 chimpanzees are being used for medical research. There's, of course, a fierce debate about the need for that, about whether chimps are good models for some diseases, and about the moral implications of using our closest animal relative in experiments. But this story is about what happens after the tests are over. Increasingly, labs are trying to retire their chimps to find other ways to do their research. But where does a chimp go when a lab no longer wants it? Recently, we were at the very first chimpanzee retirement center ever to operate in Canada. We were there, in fact, on the very day that some of the most difficult chimps to retire arrived.
Binky was born in the lab. He was 2 days old when they first drew blood from him. Annie was born in 1960. Then in her teens, she was put into research. Rachel was 4 years old when she was walked into the lab and just left there. And she's had 11 very difficult years.
Late October on the south shore of Montreal. It's mostly quiet rural farmland here, but on this farm, inside this nondescript building, is something truly out of the ordinary.
Ready for your popsicle?
Boy.
For the last several weeks, Gloria Groh has been getting to know 7 chimpanzees. The youngest is 8. The oldest is in her 30s. All of them were once used for medical research at a New York university.
When I turned 40, I decided I wanted to do something really different, and I wanted to go meet chimps. And it ended up, a friend of mine sent me an Earthwatch magazine, and in it was caring for chimpanzees, and it was in Ellensburg, Washington. Spent 2 weeks there and found out that it's possible to build a sanctuary for a chimpanzee.
What different kinds of animals do you have here?
Oh, we have.
Gloria's compassion for animals didn't come out of the blue. She and her husband are also committed to caring for abused farm animals and cast-offs from zoos. Proof of that is all over their farm. But chimpanzees? That was something very different. A reminder of why she's doing it isn't far away.
So these are where they originated, eh? These are old cages?
Mm-hmm. The oldest, the first type they used were these ones. Not so much visibility.
This was their life for however many years?
40 to 50, probably.
These cages are the minimum required by the U.S. government. They're 5 feet by 5 feet by 7 feet. As well as being the cages they lived in, these were also the way the chimps were delivered to Gloria. She's used the doors to help build her sanctuary, as well as other bits and pieces for walkways and such. But to make her sanctuary a home, she needed some expert help. Mary Lee Jensvold works at the Chimpanzee and Human Communication Institute in Ellensburg, Washington, where Gloria got the idea for her sanctuary. Mary Lee has spent the last 2 weeks with Gloria, helping her understand chimp behavior and giving her tips about the best way to keep the chimps healthy and happy. What do you think of this whole, this place overall? I mean, how?
My reaction is just, I think this place is fantastic. The job that Gloria's done is great. She's done a fantastic job. I'm really impressed. I thought she was crazy, but she's done it and everything's working and the chimps are incredibly happy.
Space is an important part of it, of course. The chimps here have tunnels across the top of the facility, as well as smaller areas they can move in and out of. But there's a lot more to keeping a chimp active than just giving it space.
This is the enrichment room, is that what you call it?
Yeah, this is like the big playroom, so it's a bigger area for the chimps to move around.
Right.
What Gloria's done here is she's done a great job in avoiding what can happen in a captive situation, and that is it's an institution. So you can get a deadening routine going on. And over here, there's a chimp on the wall, and one of the volunteers told me that the chimps that are living here, the residents, were touching that picture. So they are responding to what's on the wall.
It's funny. It really does feel like we're at nursery school or a daycare, you know, feeding,
but that's great.
Preparing lemonade.
You know, that means, if you have that feeling, then that means that Gloria is really, really successful at what she's doing. Because hopefully the chimps have that sense too. It means it's not sterile. It means it's a stimulating environment.
People aren't allowed into the enrichment area with the chimps, but when the chimps are let in, they have an obvious interest in the food, the toys, and the space they have to explore.
What have been the most difficult things for you so far?
Getting the building finished. That's been a real stress. These guys have had to live with welders and, you know, unfinished stuff and no routine. Our worry too is if something happens to someone and how we're going to deal with that, like medically. Say we had a big fight. I mean, they're just working out their social group. They haven't lived together ever before. And if we had a rip or a wound that we had to stitch or something, then we'd have to get that person out and do something to them. And then they'd feel that they're back to the same thing again, you know? You know, we were worried, what would we do if we had to start knocking folks down? How would we deal with that? You know, the last thing we want to do is use our trust to get them to come over for an injection or something like that.
How the chimps relate to each other and how the humans try to help, it's all complicated enough with 7 chimpanzees. But today, 5 more are added to the equation. In many ways, this is the moment Gloria had always planned for. Inside this truck are 5 chimpanzees, all of whom have been injected with HIV, the virus that in humans leads to AIDS.
These guys deserve it so much.
These were the chimps Gloria most wanted to retire. Like the 7 she already has, these also come from LEMSIP, a lab at New York State University that's closing down.
Oh, you look great.
Jim Mahoney is the chief veterinarian of that lab. And today, he's helped bring the chimps to their new home.
Yeah. So what do you think of a place like this?
I think it's incredible. It's fantastic. It's impossible to describe that such dedication and effort could go in to create something like this.
Why did you decide to arrange this, to have the chimps come from your lab to here?
Well, if we think we have, I won't say a right to use these animals in research, but if we think we have a need for the betterment of human health, then I think we have to be prepared to pay the price for doing the decent thing for the animal.
Are we ready to let her in? Go on in.
Because these chimps have HIV, they will never have physical contact with the first group. That presents problems for Gloria. She's had to give them their own enrichment area. And moments after they're released, they begin tentatively to explore it. Using blankets to build a sleeping nest is also a first sign the new chimps are settling in.
You must be so happy to see this.
Well, this is wonderful. That's the moment you wait for, something like that.
This isn't quite the end of the story. Three more chimpanzees with HIV were supposed to be with this new group. Health and other problems have delayed their arrival. But when they come, that will bring the total to 15. This facility can't really take many more, but 15 is a start.
There's a theory that someone that's lived in a cage and had terrible things done to them for their whole life is wasted and ruined and crazy and not retirable. But these guys are showing that they can have a life.
The three other chimps with HIV did finally arrive at Gloria's facility in early November. So far, all the animals are adjusting well to their new home. If you want to know more about the Fauna Foundation and the chimps there, here's how you can get in touch with them. When Animal Tracks comes back, the man who looks
through years of selfless service to humanity in New York test labs, 15 chimpanzees have won a new lease on animal life in Canada. They've been adopted by a Quebec woman who built a chimp camp to see them through their retirement from public life. And when it comes to making them feel at home, as Jim O'Connell reports, Gloria Groh doesn't monkey around.
It's a peaceful place where wildlife flourishes. A storybook farm near Montreal, where the majestic sounds of nature echo across the land. And these are the newest residents, a lively bunch of immigrants who were downright tickled to be here. Meet Gloria Groh, the dedicated den mother of this adopted family, as proud as any parent.
And they're very much like kids. I call it the giant daycare of chimpanzees.
Thanks to Gloria, these 15 chimpanzees are able to retire in style from a public service career that scarred them for life. They spent years at this New York laboratory, subjects of medical research into everything from AIDS to hepatitis. When their time was up, no one knew exactly what to do with them, except Gloria, who brought them home to Canada for a desperately needed injection of love.
Well, I really do love them, more and more and more and more and more. They're like another tribe of people to me that I just don't understand completely. And the more I know them, the more I'm understanding them.
Like any family, they love a party. And today, the birthday girl is 10-year-old Petra. Petra has a stress problem. Used for hepatitis experiments, she became aggressive, even psychotic. All interaction is through bars because they could still be dangerous. But what a cast of characters. Yoko was once a circus chimp. He used to love a raw egg and a shot of brandy before bedtime. Jean has a wonderful personality, but years of experiments, including injections of the AIDS virus, pushed her to a breakdown. Then there's old Tom, a 30-something casual kind of guy who fancies his cup of tea.
Here you go. Be careful because it's hot, buddy.
If he knew sign language, I bet he would be talking. And I'm sure he's saying a lot. We just don't understand the darn thing he's saying.
They all thrive on attention. In fact, our interview was interrupted by a smart aleck in the peanut gallery.
Oh, Pat, he's gonna throw that feeder. And he's gonna, where did Pat go? Billy.
They're all practical jokers, and some are crack shot spitters.
The only way to get the guy to turn and look is to give him a great big spit.
And running the chimp camp demands the discipline of a drill sergeant. Groceries alone cost more than $15,000 a year. Everything from soup to nuts.
The menu tonight is, Jell-O for dessert, for sure. Some folks will have pudding. And then our enrichment tubes. These are the best part.
Enrichment tubes.
Yeah, these guys really love them. Oh, there are all kinds of wonderful, delightful things in there. Raisins, peanut butter, marshmallows, molasses, jelly beans. And they know when they get a tube of jelly beans. It's really different. They react so differently.
Supper looks like a summer picnic, a delicious mix of fruits, vegetables, and potato chips. Suddenly, old Tom throws a fit, simply because he wants his food first.
Tom, take your mind off of it. Come here, look at some fruit. Look, take what you want. Jeez. You know, you're getting very possessive.
After dinner, the place quiets down, and the residents watch a bit of TV. One of their favorites is the Playboy Channel. Billy could watch it for hours.
He loves girls. He does. But his favorite are blondes.
But there's little downtime for Gloria, cleaning cages and coddling chimps 7 days a week.
It is.
Sometimes there's a helping hand from her chums. It's all give and take.
When you get your first chimp kiss, it's a pretty special moment. You're face to face and the little lips go into a little... It's just such a wonderful moment. You just want to, like, cry.
The chimps are well cared for, but they still have to be locked up. And that's a heartbreaker for Gloria.
Now at night when I leave, I look at someone laying on the floor with their arms stretched out and just holding my hand before I leave and falling asleep with me holding their hand. You say, why are you in there? You shouldn't be in there. You know, you just feel really, really, really wrong about keeping them locked up. Well, my vision.
Gloria and her partner have poured their life savings into the chimp camp, and they're already planning to expand to an outdoor facility.
I just felt I had to do something with my life, and I really think that a lot of people have to know about what's going on with chimps.
That's really cute.
We owe them so much, and everybody does, because they've really contributed, and they did it totally involuntarily. And they all deserve the respect, and they all deserve to have a life after research.
CTV's...
Found out a medical laboratory that experimented on chimpanzees was closing. She stepped in. Then, Grove built the chimps a sanctuary on her farm in Carinya, and now she devotes her life to them. Joanna Romeliotis reports.
Jean's been poked with hundreds of needles, cut open for hundreds of operations. She's 23. Up until 6 months ago, she belonged to a lab.
Jean was one of the chimps that was the one that touched my heart the most the first day we met them. She was the chimp whose eyes I looked into and thought, oh my God, I have to get you out of here.
Chimpanzees are valuable lab subjects because their DNA is so similar to humans. In Canada, we don't use them, but south of the border, more than 1,500 chimps are being held for experimental purposes. These chimps here were in a lab in New York. When that lab was set to close, they were going to be sent somewhere else for more testing. Gro and her partner found that unacceptable, so they took more than $200,000 of their own money and built this sanctuary.
It's a mission and it's a payback for all the things we've benefited from, I guess. You know, you reach a time in your life where you feel you really have to make up for all the things, you know, just all the things we do in life in general. And we take so much, but we never give anything back. It's just a way of giving back something.
Grow Sanctuary is the only one of its kind in Canada. It gives lab chimps a place to retire. They can't go back to the wild.
Another chimp population, a wild chimp population, would probably kill these guys. That's just the nature of tribes of chimps and humans, because chimps are so humanized now, especially lab chimps and circus chimps and whatever, they would be seeking out humans.
He's just stressed.
What happens when they're stressed?
They'll act, sometimes they'll bite themselves, they'll punch themselves, fight with the other ones. It's just being locked up in the lab. It's normal behavior, I guess. They say it is anyway, I don't know.
In New York, the chimps lived alone in cages. Years of solitary confinement have taken a toll.
You be nice. No, he ain't gonna hurt you.
The chimps don't just attack themselves, they attack each other.
The other chimp bit him here.
Why?
Just until they're different groups, until they get friends with each other, they fight. And it's now they're touching each other without biting, so it's a big improvement.
Give me your toe toes. Give me those toes. I want those toes. Oh, I want that big smile.
The improvements come slowly. The chimps have been here for 6 months. Gro showers them with love and affection, convinced it helps undo the damage.
Look at that. He's sleepy. Oh.
Who else is going to be their mummy? No, I obviously I have to feel that way. Otherwise, I don't know if we could look after them properly if I didn't feel that way about them. But you grow so attached. That's why I really don't understand how people can do what they do to them.
Some of the chimps were pets before their owners sold them to labs. Gro tries to recreate the better days as best she can.
Yes, we cook like this every day for them. At least in the winter we will. Warm meals on cold winter days. Some of them are used to that type of life, the life before the labs. So you want to bring them back to their happier days.
Hot meals.
Hold your bottle up.
Even hot tea. Gro doesn't skimp on anything.
They sort of free feed throughout the day. We give big lunch boxes, you know. And then at night we serve a proper supper, like on plates, and then you just go around at the end of the night and offer the bowl to everyone, and they can choose what they want at the end of the night. So that way you know everybody has as much as they need or want. And one thing we do have are some obese situations coming up. So we know we're not underfeeding, but I think that'll wear off once they're outside, you know, and running around a little more. Chancey! Chance! Aw. Aw. Oh, she's so mad. She's so mad. Look at her. She's very insecure. She was born to a mother with hepatitis, and they took her instantly from her mother. And she spent her life in a very small unit and mostly by herself.
Years in a lab left chimps like Chance emotionally scarred. Others are physically scarred. Billy is HIV positive. So is Jean. Researchers infected them to test antibodies to the virus. Gro keeps them separate from the others.
I don't think you can get the HIV virus just from looking at someone with the HIV virus or hanging out with them or whatever. I think they've been through so much and they had no other destiny, and that probably was another reason why we felt, you know, a particular desire to help them, because there wasn't any hope for them.
Were you ever nervous?
At first when we went and then kind of learned that it was, you know, this only transmitted through blood, and if there is one with a cut, we'll use gloves and protection and we fix them, sew them up, whatever we got to do, but that's the only danger.
Chimps don't develop full-blown AIDS. But Billy and Jean are among the oldest here. Gro knows she'll lose them first.
Well, the older guys are certainly going to die first. Now he's getting all upset. It would be like losing a family member for sure. And that thought is terrifying. But I guess that's part of life.
Come here, Billy. Where's
the Gro won't dwell on losing what she calls her kids. She's even planning for their future. She's setting up an endowment, so someone else looks after them when she's gone.
Come here, I'm gonna get that butt. Oh. What are you doing?
Joanna Vermiliotis, CBC News, Carignan.
Full-time job there, eh?
I can't get over what she was cooking for them, actually. That's pretty good.
I don't imagine they let those chimps outside today, huh?
No, I don't think so. Today would not have been a good day.
You gotta hit the button for record.
Yeah.
And then you'll be able to. I should lock this.
Well, it's from the baseball team.
Yeah, this is not working getting Petra in, but.
Is that Petra right there?
This is Jethro right there. Oh. Petra's laying at the back just looking at me.
Hey, baby. What do you think if I walk back there? I don't mean in there, I mean just to the cage area. Hi, Jethro, wave.
Might get her.
Ready, Binky? I'll try it.
Thank you.
Whoa, come on inside.
You want to come play? Do you want what we got? Hey, you want to come? Come on, come to the front.
You guys gonna catch? Oh, you missed that one. Here, Petra, give me your hand, sweetie. Yeah.
Girl, she did it.
Okay, who's next? Well, you still got your mouth full. Yeah.
He's my guy.
Can you give me this? Look, it's underneath you. Give me this.
Oh, that's because you want something from
you
me
want
now.
This?
That's exactly this? What it is.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're right.
It's okay, it's well, another container. What about you, Petra?
Diane has this idea of puppet shows.
Oh, you know.
And giving them socks.
Those kind of, yeah. But anything like that, you know, anything that they have, they can sit and watch what you're doing. It's great for them.
Do you want another one?
The percussion should go well, eh? The only thing is, one of them is a little nervous, you know, and...
One what?
One of the percussionists is a little nervous, but I'm working on it.
Well, you know what we should do? You know, within 4 to 6 weeks, we're going to have an outdoor area. And imagine, I mean, outside,
what?
Standing
you
in the
want
pasture,
another one?
Playing music.
Do you want another one?
You're
come on, give me your
you're
hand.
You're not
one.
In any danger. You don't no. have to come yeah. in here with them. And they're going to love it.
Petra!
Great.
Ooh, I have another friend who was thinking of playing guitar and singing.
You ready?
Wondering what response that
you
would
ready?
Get.
Well, there was a lady that yeah. stood here singing to them once, and it was a riot the way they responded. And they were just doing this silly thing with Regis the other day, and you know, like
you want some more?
Going like this to him, and he's copying,
you want some more?
You know, doing it back. So
where's your friend?
It could work out really well.
How come nobody? How come you're the only one here? Yeah, I see you. Oh, you're
okay,
just
gonna,
gonna put a show on for me?
Stuff.
Yeah, I just think you can. Jethro's been the most bored lately. Jethro really needs good enrichment.
Yeah, I really want.
Jethro's been, you know, he's been doing, you know, hurting himself.
I really
biting his hand and slapping himself. That's really bad. It's stereotypical behavior. It's a bored
I heard
behavior.
Yellow is your favorite color. Do you want yellow?
Ah, yes, look at that. But what he really likes is when people think he's great for doing what he is.
Oh, I think he's awesome. Oh, Petra. See, I'm impressed that Petra's coming around and wants to get, be a part of this action.
Oh, there's no way of getting that in there.
Want
right?
another one, Petra?
Here's it's yellow. Oh, wait, maybe.
Yeah.
Watch your hand. Can that fit under there, do you
He'll
think?
Get it under. If you let him, just watch your hand.
I just want him to hurt. Oh, that's not fair.
He can get it. Don't you worry. He'll figure it out. That's actually a good thing for him to figure out.
Come on, Jeffo. You can do it. You're a smart guy.
Everything out.
Jeffy. Jethro.
Oh, look at him looking in there.
What is that?
Oh, I don't know.
Get it. Get it, Jethro. What is it?
Sorry, Jethro. It is an animal product. That's why I don't use it.
Can you open that?
I don't know. I wonder if he's going to try and turn that or he's just going to rip.
Is he eating it?
Ripped and tear thing. He's trying to break it.
Oh!
These guys are playing.
Now, who's this?
There's a zipper.
Hanging up there. And this binky smack at his feet.
Well, he's got an agenda. What's he going to do with that?
Oh, wow.
What's that?
What's that?
Maybe I should go get you a
you
marker.
Know what? There's candies in that bag. And he said, I don't care. Can you give
you
me
want
the
some
lid?
Paper? And if
give me the lid. You're sitting on
draw
it.
Draw on something. Maybe
your
they'll draw on something.
Okay, can I have that? Look what's in here.
Show him the zipper and then
look.
Close it again.
Jethro, look.
He's more interested in the shoes, because that's a lot easier.
Jethro.
That's usually the purse lady.
Look what's in here. You ready? Look.
Oh boy.
Way to go, Diane.
But now you know what? We're just going to liquidate some for
yeah,
so
there's
have
a lot
bit more. Okay, you ready? Watch. You ready? Close it. I'm gonna close it. You ready? There you go.
Open stuff.
Can you do that?
I don't know. Where'd they go?
They're in there. Give me the bag.
Nice
give it to me.
Regis got it. Regis, it's in there.
Give me the bag.
He's gonna get those.
Oh.
Be able to take them off.
Regis, you want one? Regis, you want? All right. Hey, you guys. Come on, you're on my ball team.
Yeah.
Give me the bag.
I don't want to give you up.
Give me the bag. Give me the bag. Come on, give it to me.
Hi!
Yes. Awesome!
Smart, that guy!
I'm so scared.
Did he get it, guys?
Smart.
Look, Jethro, well, you know what? Maybe if we put a piece of string or something. Oh, look what I found, Jethro.
We need some more in there. Careful, darling.
Look.
Okay, sorry.
Are you ready for this? Watch.
I'm gonna get this on camera.
Okay. I'm gonna give you a piece of string. Okay. You see it? Okay. You ready? Mm-hmm. Now watch. Now.
Because I'm ready. I'm
Regis,
ready.
You ready? Look. Take this string. Pull it. And look what's inside. Can you see what's inside? Okay, you see them? Okay.
My pinky's got a long...
You bad
the pinky part.
Okay, Regis. Regis.
Jethro.
Regis.
Regis. Regis Jethro, yeah. Regis has a number
Regis
on his chest, too.
645.
Yeah, you don't really see Jethro's number, so Regis is...
Okay. Jethro and Regis.
Great way
I
to
I don't
distinguish.
Know who's going to... Okay, you gotta open it. You ready? How about you, Regis? You want some?
Jethro says I still can't figure that out.
Okay, give me the bag. Jethro, give me the bag.
I'm gonna get across it.
Oh, I think he's saying yeah.
Oh, no. There it goes.
That's okay.
We may never see it again.
Good, good.
Yeah,
it was
you know
a,
what?
But Binky's a smart guy.
Binky's gonna figure it out.
Binky's our guy.
Look at
oh. Go, Binky!
Go, Binky!
These guys will get all mad. Uh-oh. Pull the zipper! No, no.
What? Okay, come here. Come here. Give me a hand.
You, you get it?
You ready?
Oh, she's got it on her arm. Oh, look at that.
You want one? You want one? Gotta catch. Who's gonna catch? Give me your hand.
Careful there, Di.
There. You want one? Gotta catch it. Come on, give me your hand. Come on. There, yeah. You want one? You want one? Come on, give me your hand. Yeah. You gotta give me your hand, gorgeous. Hey, Regis, give me your hand. You gonna get it? I feel like you're testing me.
I think she's just checking you out, Di.
Do you want one? You want one, Regis?
Carefully. I'm going to keep
it.
Saying that until the point where you hate me.
Eat it. Good boy.
Di, let me know if someone's charging me, eh?
Binky, did you get those?
Yeah, he hasn't figured it out yet.
You like them, eh? Yeah. Contact. Making contact.
Well, look, do you notice they're not spitting on you and stuff?
Oh, would you spit on the person who's,
giving you jelly beans?
You want some more? You want another one?
Here we go. Can you open that? With ease, eh? Oh, geez, I should give you my jars of peanut butter I can never open.
Can you give it back to me? Give me back the container. Give me that. Regis, give me that. Give it back. Come on, honey. Give it to me. I'll fill it.
Careful.
That's it. Good boy. Good boy. Give it, throw it over. And throw it over here. Give it to me. Oh, I'm not coming that close, sweetheart. Give me the lid now. Give me the lid. Look.
Damn, watch it, eh?
Give me the top.
He's eyeing that jar of jelly beans like you wouldn't believe it.
Okay, give me the top. Give me the top. Come on, buddy. Yeah, give it to me.
Good boy. Good boy.
Oh, good boy, Regis.
Throw it over.
Good boy. Good boy. Yeah. Good boy. Yeah. Oh, he's a good boy. Yes. Give me the lid. Give me the lid, buddy. Give me the lid. Give me that. Give me that. Come on. You just want my jelly beans, eh? Isn't that right, hey? Yeah. He just wants my jelly beans. You want these? You want these? Give me the lid. I can't put my hand that close. You want these?
Give us the lid. Give us the lid.
Hey, give me that. Give me that. Push it out. This. And he's just saying, I'm getting out of my way. He's not within my way. Where'd it go? Where'd it go? Hey?
Are you still working on that purse back there?
You are so...
Has he not figured out the zipper yet?
You're so cute. I know. I see you coming. I see you coming.
Next time it'll be trail mix, face, okay, guys?
Eh? What a face you have.
I have an easier conscience with trail mix.
Well, yeah.
Give me that lid.
Well, I can
push it through.
Something else to throw at them.
Oh, look at this one over here, man. I'm watching it. This guy is just totally stealing my heart, though. You're just totally,
yeah,
totally stealing my heart. You want some?
Don't forget, he's a convict, eh?
Oh, yeah.
Who's that lying down there? What a pretty
Petra.
One.
Is that Petra over there?
Bill, remember this Christmas present? Look at it now.
You want that?
It's the last minute this morning. Did you give him a crayon to see if he'd write on it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, just turn the page.
The crayon ended up being something to eat.
Oh.